Listen, you people.
Don't you think we ought to go inside?
I'm getting a runaround over here. Hey, Wanda.
Halcyon Parcel Service is proud to be the colony's only parcel delivery service.
Of course you are.
How may I be of assistance?
Yeah, I got this notice to pick up a parcel.
I must respectfully ask that you calm down, please. Parcels must be picked up at window A.
I am calm. Can't you just get it for me?
Maintaining proper window structure is imperative to the smooth operation of HPS.
You kidding me?
If you would like to lodge a complaint about the quality of your service, please request a complaint form at window C. If you would like to request a complaint form at window C, please make an appointment.
And let me guess, if I want to make an appointment, I have to request a form.
I see you're familiar with our company policy.
Window A.
How may I be of assistance?
I'm here to pick up a parcel for Celeste Jolicoeur.
Of course. If you could just verify for me that you are Jolicoeur, Celeste, or an officially authorized proxy?
Here, yes. Celeste gave me this.
Everything seems to be in order. Here you are. One parcel. I hope this has been a pleasant and satisfying transaction.
Not really.
Halcyon Parcel Service thanks you for your patronage.
You're not welcome.
How may I be of assistance?
Now that you have Celeste Lapel, she can finally pass the finishing touches on her prototype. Why I care, I have no idea. Don't look at me like that, Max. I have to go up those stairs. What? She's dead?
Hey, careful. Don't go running around in the middle of a crime scene.
What happened to Celeste?
You mean Miss Jolicoeur? She was reported for practicing a subversive aesthetic. We found her in her office, working on something perverse. She didn't cooperate, so we had to put her down.
What?
Never took her for a dissident sympathizer.
You killed Celeste? That's insane.
No argument there. Feels like the whole colony's going insane. What with dissidents infiltrating the walls of Byzantium. Byzantium cultural standards are enforced by Universal Defense Logistics. Universal Defense Logistics. Your first and last line of defense in the war against sedition.
You gotta be freaking kidding, all this for nothing? She had three bits on her? Oh, Celeste's key. Somehow even Celeste's keys are stylish. Is this stuff still steel? Yeah. Now, if I open this with her key, not attacking me good. Celeste is dead, but she may have left her prototype suit behind. Why do we want it exactly? Well, there it is. Wow, two quests. What was it called again? It was a long title. Celeste was killed by the board for creating subversive and perverse designs, but not before she made one prototype suit of her greatest work, which is now in your possession. Lucky me. What the hell is it? Chimera. Jolicoeur. 53 armor. Dialogue skills plus 10. An exquisite outfit crafted by Celeste Jolicoeur. This suit provides as much protection as standard heavy armor. It's a step down from mine. It's, yeah, 10 less, but I wonder if we can improve it. Tinker it, because it gives me dialogue skills. I like that. Well, that's sweet. At least something did come of it.
I can take a hint.
I don't think it's worth it to try to get that thing. Even though she's dead, these people still hang out in here. Ah, sad. She was kind of insane, but she was interesting. Well, we've got two things left to do. Travel to the Hope and speak to Sophia. Please with my results. I'm here. I might as well just do it. Do it here. Where is she?
What do you suppose all that ruckus in Celeste's shop was about?
It would be unseen.
I need to get back up.
You cannot understand the problem until you free yourself from the desire for an answer.
Okay. So once I don't care anymore, then I know what the problem is. She's in this building. Okay. Hi. I don't know why I agreed to meet her. I don't know what could come of this. In there. You know, I thought it looked like a portrait of somebody, you know, looked like a some kind of cloak or coat on, but that's not a person's head. Hi.
I admit part of me expected you to stand by your old friend. For better or worse, Wells was responsible for putting you back on your feet. That said, he's also a wanted criminal. For information regarding his whereabouts, you are entitled to collect a reward from Percival.
What's going to happen to Wells?
The signal you sent us is experiencing some interference. My agents will need time to isolate the problem.
Doesn't answer my question.
We're going to monitor Wells until we're ready to make a move. I asked you here to discuss something far more important.
Oh, really?
I understand you've infiltrated the Ministry. The things you discovered there must have been shocking. Even disturbing. Halcyon is on the verge of a total systems collapse. The truth is ugly and difficult to accept, but we must accept the truth before we can move forward.
Okay.
Malnutrition is already a problem. Disease will come next, followed by starvation, followed by a breakdown of society, followed by extinction. I know this must come as a surprise to you. I imagine you have questions.
What's in this for you? There's gotta be an angle. There always is for people like you.
Kind of already knew this, though.
I appreciate your skepticism, Dr. Fenhill. But I'm not doing this for any personal gain. My angle is the preservation of our colony by any means possible. Nothing more and nothing less.
The powerful make the mistakes and the powerless are left paying the price, as it has always been. Tell me, Adjutant, have you anything to offer beyond the usual false platitudes?
I'm offering decisive action, Vicar DeSoto.
Hmm.
I can no longer depend on lazy, weak-willed bureaucrats to help me rescue Halcyon. I need someone with a backbone, someone like your captain. I won't pretend the truth isn't damning. Yes, the colony is on the verge of collapse, but there is a way to save it.
We need to talk about this lifetime employment program.
I'll answer however I can.
How long do we have?
We've already crossed the point of no return. The collapse has already begun. You must have noticed the signs in Emerald Vale. Malnutrition, disease, high mortality rates. This is a permanent famine, Captain. We've done all we can to curb their hunger. Very soon, people are going to realize they're starving. A famine is a problem of logistics as well as marketing. Your workers must remain productive on as little food as possible, and they must always believe that food is plentiful.
That's what that research in Roseway was all about.
Before you interfered in Roseway, Dr. Anton Crane was on the verge of developing a powerful appetite suppressant. It would have made his career. The solution is a temporary one. Before long, our workers are going to feel the effects of starvation. The lifetime employment program is our only viable option.
You don't honestly believe all this lifetime employment nonsense, do you?
The lifetime employment program is not some malevolent strategy of an evil mastermind. There's no dark secret buried in the fine print. The program is logical, it's reasonable, it's merciful, and most importantly, it will work.
I saw the presentation. Rockwell wants to sacrifice the colony to save Byzantium.
Byzantium is the beating heart of our colony. And as long as Byzantium survives, Halcyon may one day recover from the collapse. We must protect this city at any cost. Help me execute the lifetime employment program, and you will have earned a place of honor in Byzantium. You will live in comfort and want for nothing.
You guys can't live without the workers. You kidding me? You people in Byzantium doing manual labor? You'll faint. What's your take on all this?
When I first discovered the truth, I was shocked. Even disgusted. I wondered how we'd allowed a colony like Halcyon to fall into disarray. But the more I thought about it, the more I realized the colony had sown the seeds of its own destruction. We have become lazy and decadent. We smother ourselves in meaningless bureaucracies. We deliberate and argue and procrastinate.
I agree with you.
You realize that agreeing with me won't get you any kind of pay raise. Nevertheless, I'm pleased to hear that.
What does any of this have to do with me?
When you turned Phineas Wells over to me, I knew I could rely on you.
Huh.
You've demonstrated your ability to place duty above sentiment.
If only she knew.
And you deliver results. That quality alone is enough to separate you from the board's army of indecisive bureaucrats.
Not a fan of bureaucracy?
Do you know how many meetings I have to sit through? How many papers I have to sign before I can make one decision? I'm only trying to rescue Halcyon from extinction. I can't save this colony alone. I need someone capable of working outside the system. Someone who can get things done.
Alright, well, you wanted to do me some... You want me to do something. What exactly do you want me to do?
We need to talk about Emerald Vale. You handed Edgewater over to a band of dissidents. I can't have this. Adelaide McDevitt and her people have no place in the Halcyon that is to come. Edgewater needs to go. I want you to wipe the town out. No survivors.
I get that you board types are all about efficiency, but isn't this a bit much?
Wipe the town out?
I'm asking your captain to amputate a rotting limb from the colony. I'd expect you to understand, Dr. Fenhill.
I cannot condone this plan. Wanton, senseless destruction of life is never the solution.
Right.
I don't need you to approve of my plan, Vicar. I need you to get it done. Now is not the time for half measures, Captain. I need a decision from you.
I don't understand. What did Edgewater do to deserve this?
You replaced a loyal, if hard-headed, town leader with a revolutionary. Adelaide's people have turned Edgewater into a hub of dissidents. These people are dangerous. They're going to become more dangerous after the collapse. We need to put them down. Now.
Why me?
Because right now you're the only person I can depend on. My hands are tied by endless rolls of red tape and bureaucratic limitations. Halcyon is going to collapse while the board hems and haws and debates minutiae. We need to act. And you're the only person with the wherewithal to do what's necessary. I'm not asking you to be a murderer. I'm asking you to be a surgeon. Edgewater is a necrotic limb on the body of the colony. It must be severed.
Can't do that. Adelaide's people are self-sufficient. They're not a strain on the colony's resources.
Don't fool yourself. The dissidents occupying Edgewater are rebels harboring dangerous and seditious ideas. Left to their own devices, their numbers will grow. Graham Bryant and his merry band of morons caused enough trouble on Monarch. I won't risk the same thing happening in Edgewater.
Yeah, I'm not gonna kill all them. The answer is no.
Don't make this more difficult than it needs to be, Captain. I rather like you. And I'd hate to have you shot for disobeying a direct order.
Disobeying a direct order. I'm not part of your militia. Nah, go to hell.
I'm disappointed. I was so sure you had potential.
Whoop. Oh, damn it. Huff, huff, no! Okay. Could have gone better.
Oh, good. A fight.
Ah. How far back is the quick save?
I admit, part of me expected you to stand by your old... That said, he's also a wanted criminal. The signal you sent us, we're going to...
I tried my best to pick all the same...
Malnutrition is already a problem.
Options.
I know this must...
What's in...
The power...
I won't pretend the truth isn't damning. I'll answer however I can. We've already crossed the... A famine is a problem of logistics as well. The solution is a temporary one. Before long, our workers are going to... The program is logical. It's reasonable. It's merciful. And most importantly, It will work. Bazan, help me execute the lifetime employment program. And you will have... When you turn Fenny and you deliver results, that quality alone is enough to separate you from... Do you know how... I can't save this colony. When I first... But the... We have become lazy and decadent. We smother ourselves in meat. You realize that agree. We need to talk about... You have... Edgewood.
I get that you...
I'm asking...
I can't...
I don't need you... Now is not the time for half measures, Captain. You replace... These people are dangerous. They're going to become more dangerous. Because right... Halcyon... I'm not asking you to be a murderer. Don't fool... Graham Bryant and his merry band of morons call... Don't make this more difficult than it needs to be, Captain. I rather like you. And I'd hate to have you shot for disobeying a direct order.
Multiple times. Multiple shootings. I don't really have a choice, do I?
Not true. You can choose to say, yes, ma'am, or at once, Madam Adjutant, or as you wish, or even, I'll take care of it.
All right, you've made your point. I'll do it. I'm not gonna do it.
Edgewater is beyond saving. We're going to have to erase the town, but we're going to do it systematically. You were in the Emerald Vale geothermal plant. Do you remember what you discovered there?
Yeah, automechanicals went haywire and murdered everyone.
You've been paying attention. You're absolutely right. In fact, Spacer's Choice manufactured the incident for an insurance claim. They outfitted their mechanicals with a termination protocol, which is exactly what we need.
Hold on, are you telling me Spacer's Choice got away with it?
The insurance claim has been locked in committee for years, but the individual responsible for the accident was promoted for lateral thinking. I'm arranging for a delivery of mechanicals to Edgewater. These mechanicals have been equipped with the same termination protocol, which must be activated from a terminal in the plant. Once the mechanicals are finished cleaning out Edgewater, I'll need you to go in and clean out the mechanicals. Understand?
Yeah, fine. I just want you to know you're a cold-blooded psychopath.
I appreciate the flattery, Captain. One last thing. Spacer's Choice sent a team of soldiers to investigate your little misadventure in the geothermal plant. Tread lightly.
Can't you just call them off?
I like you, Captain, but you're not worth that much paperwork. I prefer keeping our relationship strictly off the books. Report back to me when the job's done.
Yeah, there's no way I'm doing that.
Get rid of Edgewater. I'll deal with the consequences.
Harlow. Does the name Clyde Harlow mean anything to you?
Ah, yes. Clyde Harlow and his gang of erstwhile outlaws living on the dark end of Scylla. He was useful. For a time. But impossible to work with. Too much ego, not enough sense. Frankly, I think he could have learned a lesson in freelancing from you.
Yeah, I'm not doing that. Edgewater has become a leech on the colony's dwindling resources. Adjutant Akande wants you to wipe out the town. She has a number of Spacer's Choice brand owner mechanicals waiting at the Edgewater landing pad. She needs you to travel to the Emerald Vale geothermal plant and send the termination protocol from a terminal. The termination protocol will order the owner mechanicals to wipe out everyone in Edgewater. Percival. Check in with Percival for your reward. Really? I thought that was done with. Okay. Hi, Percival. Are you gonna give me some stationery?
Adjutant Akande has instructed me to reward you for information leading to the arrest of Phineas Wells. Please allow me to extend my felicitations on a job well done.
He hasn't been arrested yet, right? Thanks, Percival. I appreciate it.
Quite so, madam.
All right.
Something on your mind?
As always, I am at your disposal. Anything you'd like to discuss?
I would hate sitting there knowing that people walk out of that elevator right towards me with my back turned. Just had to mention that. Perfect block. Alright, back to the unreliable. We are not activating that. We're not wiping them out. We're gonna go to the Hope.
A reminder to all crew members. There is only one toilet on the ship.
See if anyone has anything to say before we embark on what's probably our final mission.
Something busted, Captain?
Nope. They probably don't have anything to say.
Something on your mind?
Hey, hold on a second. I want a word.
Of course you do. Stand right there, though. I just want to check with Nayoka.
Shit, get off the pot, damn it. Are you listening in there? You can't be hogging the facilities for 40 damn minutes. You ought to see Ellie. You got a condition or something.
Hey, Cap.
Yes, you caught me ruminating again. What's occupying your thoughts?
Not what you were doing? You ruminating?
On standby for command.
You're not really thinking of going through with this plan, right? Tell me I'm imagining things.
I'm not doing that.
That's Parvati's hometown. You're just gonna wipe it out?
Nope.
Vicar Max lived in Edgewater. We got folk from our own crew that called that place home.
I'm not doing it. Wait. None of the above. Yeah, I'm not happy about this job.
If you don't like this job, and I don't like this job, and nobody else on this ship likes this job, then why are you going through with it?
I'm not.
Edgewater is a corporate town, not some marauder camp. They're asking you to wipe out their own people.
Why can't I tell him I'm not actually doing it? I know what I'm doing, Felix. Trust me. What I'm doing is not doing it.
I want to trust you, boss. But I'm going to need more than just your word. I need an explanation.
I guess I can't tell him. Right? Or it might get out. Then I'm... It might reach back to... What's her name? I understand you're upset, but there's not a lot I can do for you.
I ain't asking you to do anything for me. I'm asking you to do the right thing. And if you can't, then we're not going to be on good terms. Never mind. Let's just move on.
I am not going there. I'm going to the Hope. And I'm also going to hope that Phineas does not actually turn in. Guy, the way that guy put it said it was leading to the arrest of Phineas Wells. So it makes me think in the future. Not yet. So I was just in Akande's office and they hadn't found him yet. So I wouldn't think I'd just walk out of her office and ta-da, found him. Anyway, stay tuned for next episode, guys, when we land the ship in one of the Hope's docking bays and try to skip the Hope to Terra 2. Oh, wait. Actually, stand by. Because I got skills. I got mad skills. I just want to get some of this up. Get the that stuff up. Dialogue stuff. I got a perk. Small amount of melee damage. No, that undo melee. Area of effect. Takes a science weapon damage. Ellie. This is good. She comes back with 25% health. That one. Felix. I guess they all have that one. I do like that one. As you may notice. Oh. All right, that's everyone. Including myself. So anyway, next episode, guys, The Hope. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and always seek adventure.